My dear students, good morning. Let us now see a poem in Unit 4 written by Ralph Waldo Emerson. Actually, we consider it as a poem, but if you observe very carefully, the title is Fable. What is fable, you know? Fable, F-A-B-L-E. Now, I don't want to talk to you about fiction, prose, non-fiction and etc. But, for our clarification, you go through the sentence which has been written on the board. What is fable? This fable or a fairy tale or the short poem. I don't say it is a ballad, a sonnet or an ode or a lyric or elegy. But, as it is said, a fable written by Ralph Waldo Emerson. My dear students, try to understand what is actually a fable. A fable is a traditional star story that teaches a moral lesson, especially one with animals as characters. Please go through it. Fable is nothing but a traditional short story that teaches a moral lesson, especially one with animals as characters. After going through the poem or this fable, you may get a doubt. Suppose if we consider this fable as a moral or a traditional story, animals as characters, suppose there you will see mountain and squirrel. Coming to the path of squirrel, you may think it belongs to animal, but some of the students, if they don't think in the wider sense, they may get a doubt about mountain. In that case, let me advise you, my dear students, think it about flora and fauna. There ends the matter. Think about flora and fauna. Okay. Now, let me tell you, this is actually a traditional star story or a kind of poem, a fable. As it is said, it teaches a moral lesson. Perhaps you might have learnt many lessons as we have learnt in our school days. I have read it somewhere when I was a student of high school or college. A lesson, the title of the lesson is The Ant and the Grasshopper. The Ant and the Grasshopper. Written by Somerset Maugham. It is also nothing but a traditional star story. It teaches us a moral lesson. About there we see the ant and the grasshopper. But coming to the path of, if we want to say it is a fairy tale is nothing but actually, if you think about John Keats, who wrote many ballads. La Belle Dame Sans Merci. La Belle Dame Sans Merci is one of his famous ballads. It is a longer poem actually. But here, let me talk to you straight away. Here, a fable is nothing but a traditional short story. Try to understand very carefully in the very beginning. That teaches us a moral lesson, especially one with animals as characters. Here, in the very beginning of the poem, before going to read out the poem, I shall explain you the theme of the poem. The theme of the poem is not to judge others, but to understand that all of us have different qualities and talents. What is the theme of the poem? Not to judge others merely, but to understand that all of us have different talents and qualities and abilities. Here, in the fable, particularly written by R.W. Emerson, try to understand, the squirrel responded to the mountain just by saying that although it is small, it is more lively and energetic. Both of them have different talents, different qualities. If it cannot carry forest on its back, that is squirrel, neither can the mountain crack a nut. Now we can understand. Actually, once again, just as I read, you go through it. Here in the fable, the squirrel responded to the mountain by saying that although it is small, it is more lively and energetic. Both of them have different talents, different capabilities. If the squirrel, or if it cannot carry the forest on its back, Neither can the mountain track another. Not possible. Talents and qualities differ, but each one is unique in one's own way. As far as we are going to see, before going to read the poem, to try to understand about the mountain and squirrel, talents and qualities differ, but each one is unique in one's own way. Now, let me read out the poem for your kind reference. Just try to understand the rhyme scheme as I read, because of the accent and lip movement, and try to understand with the voice modulation I go through the poem. You try to understand. A fable written by Ralph Waldo Emerson. The mountain and the squirrel had a quarrel. Actually, what quarrel means here? There is an argument between the mountain and the squirrel. The mountain and the squirrel had a quarrel. And the farmer, a farmer means the mountain, called the latter. Latter means the squirrel. And the farmer called the latter, "You little prick. You little prick." Maybe ironically or satirically, this mountain made some comments on the squirrel. My dear students, understand here. The mountain and the squirrel had a quarrel, and the farmer called the latter, "You little prick or little prick." What? Who is little prick? For general meaning, let me tell you, prick means here, for your reference, a proud and narrow-minded person, and behaves in a way that he or she is the person having all the capabilities in the world. The mountain actually made some comments against squirrel. Bun replied, B-U-N, Bun, understand, you look into your textbook. Bun replied, Bun means he is squirrel, no doubt. Bun replied, "You are doubtless very big, oh my mountain. You may be big, no doubt. But all sorts of things and weather must be taken in together." Look very carefully. "But all sorts of things and weather must be taken in together. For example, as we discussed in one of our real classes for examples, here also we can quote one thing. All the seasons make a year. All the seasons, spring, summer, autumn and winter, all the four seasons they make a year. In the same way, all sorts of things and weather must be taken in together. If you say that I am a prick, if you insult me, if you look down upon me, let me tell you, even the small living creature, the fly, generally which flies in front of us, the fly which has actually, which can't shed its shadow also, even the small living creature, it has its own talents. It has its own capabilities. It has its own significance and importance. How can you say, by seeing at me and my size, how can you make a comment? You are doubtless very big, but all sorts of things and weather must be taken in together to make up your ear and your spear." Look, my dear students, the rhyme scheme here. "You are doubtless very big, but all sorts of things and weather must be taken in together to make up your ear and your spear. And I think it no disgrace to occupy my place. I don't bother. Since you are a big in size, if you look down upon me, if you ill-treat me, if you insult me, don't bother. If I am not so large as you are not so small as I. I may not become as large as you. Can you become as small as I?" Try to understand, my dear students. If I am not so large as you are not so small as I, and not half so spry. If not half so spry, I have full of energy and life, but you don't have that life and energy. In size, you may be large, I may be small, but I am very energetic, enthusiastic. I have life now here. Now, if I am not so large as you are not small as I, and not half so spry. I will not deny you make a very pretty squirrel track, since you are big in size, because of your ego and some other qualities. You can do anything. You can make a path, and you will do, and you will dominate. Suppose, see, I will not deny you make a very pretty squirrel track, if possible. It is possible for you, no doubt. But talents differ. Understand? Talents differ. All is well and wisely put. My dear students, carefully observe this sentence. All is well and wisely put. In the very beginning of the universe, when this universe was created, some unknown power, some supernatural element, or the creator, he created this entire universe with a kind of setup and concept. How can you say? Talents differ, that's all. Only talents differ. All is well and wisely put. All is well and wisely put. What does it mean here? All the living creatures, the flora and fauna, all the living creatures have been created with a concept by that unknown power, by the creator. If I cannot carry forest on my back, I may not carry you on my back because you are big. Neither can you crack a nut as I do when I am jumping on the branches of the trees and going for food. If I cannot carry forest on my back because I am very small, neither can you crack a nut. I think you can't do that. So, before going to judge others, you think in the wider sense. We should not make comments. We should not talk against fellow human beings also, ironically and satirically and humorously. Humor is essential, no doubt. For each and every human being, humor is essential. Essence of humor, in other words. So anyhow, once again, I go through the poem in 2 minutes. The mountain and the squirrel had a quarrel, and the farmer called the latter, little prig. One replied, you are doubtless very big, but all sorts of things and weather must be taken in together to make up a ear and a spear, universe. And I think it no disgrace to occupy my place if I am not so large as you. You are not so not so spry like me, because I have full of energy. I am energetic. I have life, but you don't have. I will not deny you make a very pretty squirrel track. Talents differ. Understand? All is well and wisely put. The entire universe has been created in the very beginning with a concept. If I cannot carry forest on my back, neither can you crack a nut. Here, as it is said, the moral of the theme of the poem is not to judge others, but to understand that all of us have different qualities and abilities. They are unique. Okay, just go through the poem very carefully and try to understand the gist of this particular fable. Thank you.